What's up? I'm still up. So I got a new wig off of Amazon. Love you, brother. By
the way, one soda stream bottle can save,
I don't know, thousands?
Yeah, thousands of single-use plastic bottles. So who's thinking
of
he's the season.
Now, I'm going to
warm feet.
Fix it with makeup.
Find a fine life, baby.
Holiday shopping simple. On Poshmark, you'll get deals on fashion, home decor, and more. With 9,000 brands at prices up to 70% off, you'll find something for them and savings for you. Now that's a happy holiday. Download the free Poshmark app today.
This is True Crime Story on Sundance TV.
We want to start a new conversation.
Real stories
from fresh perspectives.
Finally, people are listening to the one that's tapes.
True Crime Story, next.
You were so angry with your mother, you wanted to kill her?
Yes.
So you killed another woman instead?
Dolores was as close as I could get.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. How did you kill Dolores Diamond?
With a knife.
How many times did you stab her?
I don't know.
I can help you with that. According to the medical examiner's report, you stabbed her 5 times. And then slit her throat. Each wound was a fatal one.
If that's what it says.
You invited Miss Diamond to dinner, asked her back to your room, and then you stabbed her to death with a weapon you had purchased earlier that day.
Yes.
A premeditated, violent, vicious slaying, and you're serving a term for manslaughter?
Objection.
Sustained.
Dolores Diamond molested you when you were a child. Dolores Diamond gave you drugs. You were so angry with her. You lured her back to your hotel room to kill her.
Your Honor, does counsel intend to ask a question?
Mr. Granger?
Isn't it true, Mr. Rance? Oh. In return for a manslaughter plea, you concocted this story against your mother in order to please the district attorney.
No. That's the truth.
You didn't write the Book of Daniel.
I did not.
The people's expert witness testified that the manuscript was in your hand.
It's a forgery.
Did you ever believe in what it advocates?
When I finally obtained a copy of it and read the book, I was distressed. I ordered the book destroyed and anyone who believed or practiced its precepts expelled.
Why would someone go to all the trouble to forge this document?
To discredit me and our community.
Why?
We're a threat to the established social order, to governments and churches.
A threat? How so?
We believe in God's laws, not man's.
Your own son and daughter testified against you.
I feel so sorry for them.
Are any of the things they said about you true?
Not at all.
Are they lying?
I think they believe what they're saying. They've been manipulated. They have false memories. They feel guilty about what they did, about their relationship. And that's why I feel sorry for them. I think they're victims too.
Did you ever give your children drugs?
No, never.
You never gave your son David Quaaludes. You had a prescription for them.
He may have taken them from me without my knowledge, but I don't know.
And you never encouraged any of your children to have sex with each other or with adults?
Of course not.
And all of the testimony we've heard from ex-members, which contradicts what you're saying?
I have a lot of enemies.
Because you're such a threat to the established order of things.
Yes.
How many followers do you have, Mrs. Shelby?
were flourishing in a number of countries.
According to the FBI, you have less than 10,000.
That's a gross underestimation.
With many of the younger ones leaving as soon as they're able.
That's not true. They want to diminish us.
And charging you and your cult with sexual and physical abuse.
This campaign against us has been going on for decades.
This conspiracy against you. All lies.
There may have been a few instances, a few excesses early on, but we dealt with them.
Why, Mrs. Shelby? Why would all these people, these agencies, and governments, your own children, conspire against you?
Every great spiritual and religious leader throughout history has been mocked, scorned, persecuted. You should know that.
For instance?
Jesus, Muhammad, the Buddha, Joseph Smith, Galileo, St. Francis,
okay, so.
Mary Queen of Scots.
And you put yourself in their company?
I do.
Really no need to do anything.
How do you find? We find the defendant guilty.
This is True Crime Story on Sundance TV.
We want to start a new conversation.
Real stories
from fresh perspectives.
Finally, people are listening to the woman.
True Crime Story, next. And now, Indefensible on Sundance TV.
She was the all-American girl next door. Prom queen. Homecoming queen. Captain of her high school cheerleading squad. She was blonde. White. Just a small-town, blonde, white girl. With her whole life ahead of her. Do I have your attention? Good, because forget what I just said. I was just trying to keep you engaged because market research tells me what you want, and it's white chicks, murder, 24/7. The truth is, the women at the center of our story might not fit your typical true crime show victim profile, which is all the more reason to keep watching. Sometimes the criminal justice system isn't all that just. Each stage of sleepwalking involves murder. That's scary. Of course it is.
You don't give up, do you?
I'm Jenna Friedman, and this is Indefensible. This episode is about a guy who thought he could get away with murder by preying on vulnerable women. And what's worse is that he was right.
Some new information tonight now in the death of a college student from Montclair. Police say they have arrested a suspect in the murder of Sarah Butler. The 20-year-old disappeared days before Thanksgiving. Sarah graduated from Montclair High School. She was very popular. She was very into dance. And
you could see some of her videos of her dancing. She just has such exuberance.
Reporter Julia Martin covered the case.
She was the first in her family to go away to college. She had a lot of jobs. She was just a go-getter, and she was going to better her life.
In 2016, Sarah Butler is home for Thanksgiving when she starts messaging with a guy on the social networking site Tagged.
He had offered to get together with her and offered her money, and she had agreed reluctantly. And then she got so nervous she didn't show up. And then 2 days later, she says, "Sorry I stood you up. Sorry I was nervous. You're not a serial killer, right?"
Wow. On the evening of November 22nd, Sarah goes out to meet him. She never comes home.
The minute she disappeared, her family would not rest. They were frantic. Sarah's sister, mother, and two best friends were literally in the Montclair police station every single day.
After meeting with police, Sarah's friends take the investigation into their own hands and relentlessly pursue every lead.
They went to the Butler's house to hack into Sarah's computer. They're like, "We gotta act."
Sarah's friends soon find her Tagged account. They create a profile and arrange a date with the same guy Sarah had met up with just prior to her disappearance. When they go to meet him, they bring the Montclair police with them. Assistant Prosecutor Adam Wells.
The Montclair police didn't tell them to do this. They did this on their own. They actually went to the restaurant. A friend of Sarah's sister was standing in the door of the restaurant, waving at him to let him know that she was there. And as he started getting out of the car, the two plainclothes detectives from Montclair approached and asked him if he would be willing to help them with a missing persons investigation.
Wow, okay. That's so scary.
They were dedicated to the purpose.
The man police encounter is a 20-year-old named Khalil Wheeler Weaver, who comes from a family of law enforcement. Mm. When Sarah's body is found 5 days later, police use cell phone and DNA evidence to arrest him for her murder.
Police believe Weaver strangled a 20-year-old New Jersey City University student, killing her. He then took her car, police say, and left her body at Eagle Rock Reservation.
Sources say he was most recently working as a security guard at this ShopRite in Union.
That's a little disconcerting, I would say. Very, as a matter of fact.
Do you think that the case would have been as strong if the friends had not set up that social media profile to find the killer and apprehend him?
The friends who were looking out for each other, those friends are the ones who made sure it got to where it needed. And this is true with Sarah's case, but also with the other victims' cases.
That's right. Sarah wasn't his only victim. In fact, authorities soon learned they might be dealing with a serial killer.
I absolutely hated pricking my fingers.
You get these calluses and these sores.
Pick a finger, you know. Which one are you going to hurt today? Once I was able to use Dexcom, I could simply monitor all my phone, and I didn't have to prick. I'm not relying on a finger stick.
Belfast.
Go now. Don't look back.
Claim director Kenneth Branagh.
Be good, son.
Be good.
Be careful.
Belfast. City PG-13. Theaters tomorrow. Be the first to see the exclusive first trailer for Downton Abbey. A new era this weekend, only with Belfast.
I've always been a cat lover, and I'm here to tell you that nothing makes the litter box less of a chore than Pretty Litter. Its lightweight, absorbent crystals trap moisture and eliminate odor, and it changes color to indicate potential health issues, granting me a little peace of mind. There's never been a better time to experience a better litter box. Try it risk-free today. Ships right to you for free. Head to prettylitter.com to try it for yourself.
1-800-Flowers.com.
Wow.
Wow.
Gorgeous.
Fancy.
I am so touched.
Colorful and fresh.
1-800-Flowers.com.
It's super easy to order.
So easy.
So no excuses.
1-800-Flowers.com.
With Drive Time, you can save money on your down payment. $1,000 on average.
Awesome.
Right? Saving that much money sort of feels like...
I want to try.
Get approved and shop thousands of cars all on your phone.
You're watching Indefensible, part of True Crime Story on Sundance TV.
preparing the case against Sarah Butler's killer, they make a shocking discovery. Tracking data from Khalil Wheeler Weaver's cell phone helps them uncover two more women he murdered. On August 31st, nearly 3 months before he killed Sarah Butler, Wheeler Weaver claimed another victim, a 19-year-old from Philadelphia named Robin West.
Robin West had a family that loved her. They did their best to keep track of her, but once someone's, you know,